Hey everyone, this is Matt McCool with MotionVFX, and I'm excited to share with you our brand new transition pack for DaVinci Resolve. It's called mTransition Noise. mTransition Noise is a collection of 69 unique transitions, perfect for music videos, sizzle reels, or any other kind of stylized video. So once you have mTransition Noise installed, you can find it under the effects library, under video transitions, motion VFX, and then mTransition Noise. Here you'll see all these different noise transitions. They're split up into different categories. You have a couple of blurs, bulge, color, some of these film burn transitions, scribbles, flash, a bunch of different things to play with. And by the way, you can click on the three dots up here and turn on the hover scrub preview. And this basically just lets you audition several different transitions so you can quickly find the one you like. So I'm gonna choose one from the color section here. Let's try this color blur down. And I'm just gonna drag this straight on the cut here. If you're unable to apply a transition, then you might have a video like this one over here where there's nothing to the left of the clip for the transition to actually work. And you're not gonna be able to add a transition because just like all transitions, you actually need additional video frame handles on both sides of the cut point in order for it to work. So you can trim it back here and slide it up against the clip next to it. And you should see this green line on the cut. And now you'd be able to drag a transition directly to the cut. You can of course adjust the duration of the transition and all the effects will automatically retime depending on how long you want the effect to last. And by the way, the default duration for transitions in DaVinci Resolve is 1 second, but you can actually change that if you come up here to DaVinci Resolve, Preferences, under the User panel, you want to select Editing, and right here under the General Settings tab, you'll see Standard Transition Duration. So you can actually set this to whatever you want. So if you always have transitions that are about 2 seconds, 3.5 seconds, you can actually choose the default duration right here. I'm just gonna leave mine at 1 second and hit save. So if you click on the actual transition and then look over in your inspector, you'll see several different categories for customizing the look and feel of the transition. So you have transition controls. Here's where you can adjust the movement of each clip. So you can turn off the shake if you want, or you can independently adjust the X and Y shake. You can randomize the shake. You can also reduce the overall power. You can change the speed of the shake. Beneath that, you also have controls for blur. So you can disable it altogether. You can make it more blurry. This one has controls for smear. So again, you can turn that off. You can also adjust the scale or the position or even the blending mode of the smear. And a lot of these have controls for the dent. And you even have different controls for types of dents and the overall size and the power of the dent. And you can also enable or disable that. Prism blur is pretty much like chromatic aberration. So you can adjust kind of how blurry that prism blur effect is, the overall distance. Again, you can turn that off. And then this one being a color transition also gives you control over the color overlay. So here's kind of where you can select different parts of the color gradient. So you can click these little triangles and maybe dial in a different flavor here. So maybe something more like a yellow to blue type of color. So you can get really creative. You can also dial in the overall power of that color overlay. So that could be something to experiment with there. A lot of these transitions are heavily texturized. So let me actually delete this transition and show you something like these film burn transitions. So let me just grab one of these and drop it on here. This one actually has a lot of these really cool texture overlays. And if you click on it, you can come down to the texture controls. You could turn these off if you want, but you can also change the color of that texture and also change the apply mode. So maybe screen would be kind of a more subtle effect for this. Now grain is probably one of the more resource intense effects in these transitions. So if you want kind of a faster preview while you're messing with the settings, you could just turn this off and you will have much better performance. And then once you kind of dial in the rest of the settings, you can come down and turn it back on. And another thing you can do to really bring these transitions to the next level is adding some sound effects. So I'm going to come up to my media pool and I've got this kind of whoosh distortion sound effect. So let me add this right beneath my transition and kind of line it up with the duration. And let's hear what that sounds like. Okay, and then maybe we'll combine that with a little bit of glitch. And it looks like it's gonna be loud, I can already tell, so I'm gonna turn this down a bit and maybe trim it, fade it out, kind of like this. I think it's still probably too loud. So as you can see, this is a very powerful and flexible transition pack that makes it super easy to really spice up your projects. For more information about mTransition Noise, visit MotionVFX.com and don't forget to subscribe to the channel so you don't miss out on future goodies like this. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.